The number of middle-aged people living alone in the UK has jumped by nearly a million over the past two decades, leaving some people struggling to cope with their homes. Cue the extreme cleaners.
So, what are you actually doing today? About Paul Daniels?
Not a lot.
With 10 years' experience between them, father and son duo Steve and Jamie know that cleaning is only one part of their job.
Being an extreme cleaner, you have to be ready at any time to get stuck in to grimy situations, and most of all, you really need to be there to care and support the customer.
Today, they're in Glasgow to help a 62-year-old gentleman who's been living alone for the last 8 years, following the death of his wife.
Good morning.
Morning.
My name's Steve. How are you?
Okay, Steve, I'm Alan.
Alan, nice to meet you, Jamie.
Struggling on his own, Alan has been reduced to sleeping, eating and living in just one room.
How long have you just lived in this room, Alan?
For the last 4 or 5 years.
Right, okay.
Alan shares the room with a fridge, a broken cooker and thousands of cigarette butts.
Would you like to have a bedroom back?
Yes. I'd like just two separate rooms in a normal house.
Right.
I'd like to live as a normal person.
We'll do that for you.
Aye.
Right? Aye. Yep. I promise you, by the end of our period here, you'll sleep in a bedroom.
What used to be the bedroom is filled with rubbish.
As you can see, this is a spare room.
Okay.
I call it the junk room obvious reasons.
Okay.
The rest of the flat is no better.
As you can see, it's been neglected. It hasn't been used for a long time.
Needs a wee bit of magic in there.
Alan hasn't always lived like this.
I was married, and within weeks of each other, my wife and my best friend both passed away for cancer.
Gosh,
I got depressed, I got very isolated, and I let the place go. And as you can see, it's a long-term neglect in this place.
Right, yep.
You take care. Enjoy yourself. Right.
Cheers, Alan. See you later.
Alan's moving out for a few days while the clean takes place.
Take a look. It's a monster challenge, you know. The place is old and tired. We've got to make it clean and young. We'll see what we can do.
First, they start by disinfecting and clearing the dumping ground, formerly known as a bedroom.
Oh, that's an ashtray.
But the deeper they dig, the grimier it gets.
Hungry?
Oof.
Fancy a bacon sarnie, son?
No, it's actually maggots and flies in there.
Let's have a look.
Looks like it's carpet flies.
With only 3 days to reclaim the flat as a proper home, the boys have no time to waste.
Is that cockles and mussels?
That was ham at one time.
Ooh. Oh, my God.
Being an extreme cleaner means you see a completely different side of Britain, which can teach you a lot.
This job has taught me to be patient with everyone. Everyone from every walk of life, no matter what we do, we could be driving, we could be standing at the shopping till, we could be in the bank. Just be tolerant of different personalities.
People are very quick to judge. Now, unfortunately, they don't understand really what's put people into these situations. They just think they're lazy or they're dirty. There's a lot of different factors that make people become hoarders or even drugs. There's a trigger point or there's a story. And as society, we tend to just think first and ask questions later.
There are so many vulnerable people out there who get to a stage in their life where they need massive help. Don't judge, be compassionate, listen and care. You've got to.
Across the country, extreme cleaners are tackling Britain's worst homes and helping out those most in need.
We're just dismantling the bed, taking out of the new living room so we can create a bedroom next door.
In Glasgow, father and son cleaning team Steve and Jamie are hard at work.
See how easy we would have gone round.
Helping a 62-year-old man who's been camping out in one room following the death of his wife 8 years ago.
Well, thanks, Steve.
No problem.
Pleasure, Steve.
With only one day to complete the job, they divide up the remaining rooms.
One, two, three, deliver.
Right. So I've got this job?
Yep, see ya.
So with Steve in charge of the neglected bathroom...
I'll give him rock, papers and scissors. I've got a feeling that was fixed, by the way.
Jamie can try to rescue Alan's carpet from almost a decade of ground-in dirt, hair and food spillages.
It's going to be a long day with this carpet, but you know what? We've got it covered.
Carpets can contain up to four times their weight in dirt, which is why regular cleaning is essential. First, the floor gets a thorough going over with a specialist carpet brush.
Alan said it's been about 8 years since he's really cleaned it. I could quite believe it.
For the problem areas, Jamie uses a heavy-duty scraper.
I'm happy. I'm starting to make progress. It's time-consuming. It's hard work, but the end result's going to be so worth it.
Lastly, an industrial carpet cleaner takes out the remaining ground-in dirt.
This is from the living room carpet. Job well done.
This is where it really gets nasty.
I think he's going to be over the moon. I can't wait to see his face, so, happy.
Jamie disinfects the entire flat with an industrial cherry-scented fogger, ready for Alan's return later today.
Oh. Righty-tighty, lefty-loosey.
But in Glasgow, Steve and Jamie still have the finishing touches to complete.
Yep.
On a flat which was suffering from 8 years of neglect.
That's the polishing, just to make sure everything is 101% perfect.
After 40 bin bags, 5 litres of bleach and hundreds of old cigarette butts, it's time for Alan to see his new home.
Hi, Alan.
How are you doing? How are you doing?
Welcome home. Welcome home. Come in, come in.
3 days ago, Alan's kitchen was nothing but a graveyard for tea bags, without even a fridge. Now...
This is absolutely brilliant. I don't recognise it. It should have been in the right house. This is absolutely fantastic.
Before, this room was a dumping ground for rubbish and rotten food. And now, he has a proper bedroom again.
This is brilliant. Well done, lads. Yeah, this is fantastic. This is brilliant. I didn't realise the potential this room had until I've seen this today.
Good. Right, listen, we've got one more room.
OK.
Right, come on.
Alan used to camp out in this one room which was covered in litter, rotten food and cigarette butts. Now it's a spacious living room where he can relax.
This is beautiful. I thought it was beyond saving. Thanks, lads. This is what I wanted. Thanks a lot, thanks a lot.
Thanks,
Steve.
See you later, mate.
Thanks a million.
Pleasure's mine. Take care.
You've done me proud.
And you.
And yourself
proud. We've enjoyed
proud.
Every second of it. Take care.
Thanks, Jenny.
Thanks very much. Right, keep in touch if you need anything.
I will do.
Right, you don't take care.
Thanks,
Thank
Jenny.
You. Cheers.
OK. Everybody needs a wee bit of a helping hand. I've certainly got that. And now it's up to me to make sure that helping hand isn't thrown away. Hope I don't let the guys down. I'll keep this place as pretty near damn as good as what it is at the moment.
Another one done? I'm absolutely delighted. We have gave him a fresh start, and I fully believe that Alan's going to be the one that will keep it going, and I'm over the moon.
Happy days.